Hey, what's going on, everybody? All right, so one of the benefits of my hobby of working with leather and everything else is I get the honor of messing with a whole lot of different knives and being able to touch them, feel them, you know, and all that good stuff. So that way I can actually get a really good understanding of how those knives might perform in the field. Obviously, I don't go out and use people's knives and everything else that they send me to do leather work on. But every once in a while, somebody that sends me something wants me to go out and use it. And, you know, in the very beginning I thought, you know, I really don't want to do that. But, you know, if they have the trust in me, then, you know, I have no problem going out and using their knife or their hawk or whatever it is. I'm not obviously going to abuse it, just kind of get a feel for it. And my buddy, Mike Travis, has sent me his Skookum, or I believe that's how you pronounce it. And he wanted me to put a nice sheath on it. And he also told me to take the knife out, give it a test drive, and see what I thought. So I did. I took the knife out before I even made a sheath for it. And I fell in love with that knife. I mean, it is an absolute great, great knife. I mean, it performed, you know, camp chores and everything else really, really great. Most of the times when I get my hands on exotic knives, I'm a little disappointed that they don't live up to all the hype and everything else. But this is one that I can truly say that I was very impressed with. And this is the knife here. And the sheath that I made for you. He did want it in a dark brown, so I made it in a dark brown. He also wanted it waterproofed, so it's quite dark right now because of the waterproofer on there. But it matches real well with the knife handle itself, I think. And of course, I put, you know, my little trademark quick release dangler on there, and I'm going to show you guys exactly why I love danglers so much here in just a minute anyway. But here's the knife. I believe these were inspired by Mr. Ray Myers himself. This knife, when I first saw it, I mean, the first thing that comes to mind is a Mora. And I have compared this to my Moras, and, you know, it performs very much so like a Mora. But, I mean, this thing is absolutely razor sharp, and I just think that this is a really great knife. It is A2 tool steel. Very good steel, and not quite an eighth inch thick, but almost. But I'm telling you, what a great little knife. So let's take a look at this thing and see a little bit of how it does. All right, so I told you guys I was going to show you exactly why I liked the dangler so much. I've got on right now the ILBE assault pack, okay? And anybody that's ever worn a knife and worn a backpack at the same time know that it can be very uncomfortable if it has a waist belt. But not if you have a dangler, because it sits below that waist belt. The other thing is, in the wintertime, you have a coat on or something like that, you don't have to open up your coat to get to your knife, because it sits also below your coat line. So that's the main reason I always choose to have a dangler on. Everybody has their own idea what a feather stick is and what a fuzz stick is. Some people think they're the same thing, and they are. I mean, it's whatever, but you know, my personal opinion is a fuzz stick is very small, tight curls. Now, if I'm to make a fuzz stick, I would do this, you know, all around the whole stick and all along the whole stick. But I tell you what, this knife does a really great job of it. That's all there is to it. You can see how easy it notches. Curious to see how much effort it would take to actually chew through this stick without batoning or anything else, just simply by taking our time and just kind of working it. Obviously, it wouldn't be anything to snap it off right now, but I'm having fun digging in the wood. This thing does it so effortlessly. Just very effortlessly.
I mean, for example, if you were using, you know, a larger piece of willow or something like that, you were wanting to do a hand or a bow drill or something, I mean, look how effortlessly you'd have to work in order to notch it out. I mean, it's just insane. This thing just chews. Through this stuff. I mean, what an absolute great little knife. I mean, I have no faith or no doubt that this thing could do some damage to larger stuff. But it's not my knife, and I'm going to respect it. Just flat eats wood, though. What a great little carver. A lot of you guys have seen my Stock and Wolf knife and everything else. I'm actually looking at that. I designed that knife as a one knife for the rest of your life. Not necessarily a bushcraft style knife, but more of a survival knife. And I'm actually looking at designing a bushcraft knife as well. And I'll tell you what, this knife here has really had me taking notes. I mean, this, I just had somebody ask me the other day what my favorite bushcraft knife was other than the Stock and Wolf, and you know, my answer to that is the Stock and Wolf is not my favorite bushcraft knife, because like I said, I did not design that as a bushcraft knife. I designed it more of a, like I said, one knife for the rest of your life. If I had to choose my favorite bushcraft knife right now, this would be it. I mean, I just love the way this thing works. I'm not even doing anything but sitting here cutting through wood, but...
Alright, so let's go ahead and give this thing an actual job. What I'm going to do is I'm going to take these dead standing willows here, and I'm actually going to cut them off for future hearth boards. I send a lot of hearth boards out to people that are interested in friction fire and trying it and all that good stuff. And I also make up a whole bunch just so I can show kids and everything else that are interested and all that. So I'm just going to cut off a couple sections here. We're going to split them up, make a few little hearth boards, and see how it does. Okay, so right after I started processing this piece of willow, I actually had a couple guys come in and start practice shooting. And so rather than taking the risk of getting shot myself or talking over them, I decided to go ahead and bring it back over here at the grandparents' house. So I'm gonna finish this up out in their backyard. So let's go ahead and I'm gonna cut this thing up into a couple different sections and then we'll split it up. Okay, now these things are actually a little bit smaller than what I generally would make for a hearth board. But these are, like I said, just for practice to send out to people and everything else. So I'm gonna make them a little bit smaller so that way I can actually fit them into you know, smaller boxes and everything else. That way I don't get demolished on shipping costs. But I'm not actually going to use the Skookum to split these things. I have no doubt that it would actually split them just fine. But like I said, this is not my knife, and I am not going to put it through any type of medium to heavy use. It's just not risk. It's not worth the risk, you know, quite frankly, in my book. So what I'm going to do is I will pull out my knife and use the stock and wolf to perform this task. You know, I think is what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to use the Skookum to process this hearth board right quick, and then I actually think I'm going to grab the Stalking Wolf and do it so that way it's kind of side by side, so that way it can actually answer a few questions that I got the other night on my Facebook group. I actually had somebody send me a PM asking if I felt that the Stalking Wolf was just as good as the Skookum, or if I thought the Skookum was better. And you know, it's not a matter of which one I think is better. I think they both would complement each other very well. I just think the Skookum is more of a bushcraft style knife, and the ants climbing all over me. And the Stalking Wolf is definitely more of a survival knife. But it'd be kind of fun to put them side by side right quick and just see. I mean, the Skookum is chewing through this, you know, no problem at all. Skookum. What a fun name that is, anyway. Hope I'm pronouncing it right. Okay, so that's about where I'd stop with this hearth board. So let's put this one away. Let's grab ourselves another one and break out my little jewel and see how that works. And you can see, side by side, they both work very well. I think that's what I'm going to have to start doing, is just using other knives and then to fully test this thing out. I need to just do it side by side with all the other knives that I think are great. But you know, quite frankly, it just chewed through that hearth board, you know, very easy. Let's go back to the Skookum again. And do this one. Beautiful. And we'll go one more time with the stalking wolf. Let's see here. Both knives just, they bite quite well. That's all there is to it. Alright guys, well, I hope you have enjoyed this video on the Skookum, and Mike, I hope you like this thing, man, because I don't want to give it back. It's a great little knife, but I think you've got yourself a nice little rig now. This sheath, in my opinion, has, you know, the perfect retention. It's not too tight, but it's not too loose, and I am here to tell you, you'll never, here, let me just take the dangler off so it's not flapping around in the wind here, but quite frankly, you are never going to drop your knife out of there. That's all there is to it. I mean, it's just not going to happen. So, I hope you're happy with it. I greatly appreciate you allowing me to use your knife, and I love it. I think it's a great knife. I am definitely taking notes on a future design that I have in my head, but anyway, not going to take up any more of you guys' time, and as always, have a good one.